Blog Talk Radio.
Tarakee Billy is a spiritual advisor and certified animal communicator who has been guiding people on their sacred path for nearly 40 years. Her ability to hone in on her clients' needs has made her one of the most sought-after spiritual advisors in the country. With Tarakee Billy's guidance, you can take the first steps or refine your journey along your sacred path. Before we get going, we ask that you do your part. Have your one question ready, keep it concise, and stay on topic. One concise, on-topic question. And now, here's Tarakee Billy.
Greetings, everyone. This is Tarakee Billy, and thank you for joining me here on Sacred Path program, as we'll be talking for lightworkers. And I have my guest here. I see he's here. I'm bringing him in. Hey, Ray, are you there?
Yep, I'm here.
All right. Well, former fellow lightworker, we're here to go over things. And I thought I'd kind of give a little rundown of how, you know, am I a lightworker? How many people wonder that, right? Ray?
Yeah.
I don't know if you're hearing me or not. Am I coming through okay?
Yeah, I heard you. I got you. What's up?
Okay, well, I'm going to run through how to know if you're a light worker. Here we go. It's 9 different ways. Do you feel a sense of time urgency within you? Do you feel drawn to help humanity? Do you feel drawn to spirituality? Have you been told that, like others, that you are too sensitive? Do you feel different from others? Do you know that you're here for a higher purpose? Have you had a mystical experience such as psychic phenomenons or angelic encounters? Have you endured harsh life experiences that eroded the knowledge of your true self? Do you feel compelled to write, teach, or counsel? Now, these are just some of the ways to know that you're really a light worker. Now, you want to add any comments to it, Ray, please do, if you have any.
I've had some visions, as we have talked about before. We have talked about before, of people that were in my life that have gone on. It was strange because it just within the last 3 or 4 months, I've been seeing my dogs that I had and my horse that I had, my pony. I smell fragrances that, you know, as I said before, I work in a barn, so you don't really smell sweet fragrances when you're in the barn, so.
Not at all.
especially in a bad stall. As you had taught me, that has to be an angel that's there with me.
Oh, yeah. The fragrance of incense, that perfumey smell, is always from an angel. So anyone listening, if you have those things happen, you're being visited by an angel. Keep going, Ray. Didn't mean to interrupt.
That's okay. But I also, I'll smell perfume, stuff like that, sweet smelling stuff that I'm guessing it's either an angel, which is probably what it is, or somebody trying to contact me because I'm usually in the barn by myself. And if anybody would walk in, they'd swear I was crazy because I'm in there talking to myself. I'm really not talking to myself.
No, you're communicating beyond.
Yeah, right.
And that's okay.
So
it's all right. And you're doing work that most people wouldn't care to be doing. So, there's something about it. And I think the connection to the horses is very good for you because they're such sensitive beings. And they definitely have a connection spiritually.
Right.
That's what I've been working with animals, and I've done communication with a lot of horses. But I want to bring up a good point here that many don't understand, that if you're going through something terribly wrong, have hardships or something, you may feel you're off track. Well, not really. That's how you kind of know you're a light worker, because things won't always go easy for light workers. Let's take, for example, Jesus. He didn't exactly have it easy, and yet he was one of the high beings of light. So, you know, you've got to realize it won't always be perfect. A lot of the New Age philosophy is that if things aren't going right, then it's you causing it. I mean, I believe we should have positive thinking, but that's a little extreme. How do you feel on that, Ray?
I agree with you. I don't believe that if things aren't going right, it's your fault. I mean, unless if you're going to go out and buy a new car and you only got a $3 an hour job, then that, yes. That is your fault.
Stupidity.
But basically, you know, you're getting it. Somebody's attacking you or something to where they are, they're saying, okay, you go ahead and do this, but it's not really the right thing to do. You have to sit and you think about it. Well, you can't research it to death, as famous Amos said, but you use common sense and go from there.
Yeah, and, you know, don't feel if you can't overcome, say, a physical illness or challenges in life that you're way off path. You're just finding a new way to do things, and it's not by how you did it before. That's kind of an example of light workers. It really is. So I hope this helps people who are listening.
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No. Go ahead.
I had a pinched nerve in my back, and I know now that, hey, I can't do what I used to do. So I'm just trying to go into a different direction to figure out what I can do to still be doing things without sitting around all the time doing nothing.
Exactly. You know, one thing I found that all these challenges, and I've had a lot that I went through in my life, has been for my spiritual growth. I always come out different and stronger, you know, than I would had I not had them. I don't know if many of you who followed me for years know, but I've been bedridden for 33 years, and I do an enormous amount of work and never stop on my spiritual journey and helping others, because I got to do it, plain and simple. I don't have any choice, and this is the direction I was drawn into. Had I had not had that experience of being bedridden, I often think that I would not have went so far into my spirituality. I was in it quite a bit prior to. I studied with a lot of great teachers, but I wonder if I would have ever come to where I am now, and probably not. But, you know, it happens the way it's going to happen.
Yeah, now, go ahead.
No, you.
Just because things don't go the way you think they should go, or the way things, you know, they're going in a different direction, sometimes you have to think about, you know, is this coming from me, or is this coming from the Creator, or whatever. Maybe I shouldn't take that direction. Maybe I should go in the other direction that it's pushing me.
Mm-hmm. Very much. You know, and it's learning to the old thing, go with the flow, whichever direction you're being pulled in. Try to go with it, work with it, and deal with it as best you can. Now, there are a few callers on here, and why don't we take a call? So, let's go over here. This is area code 954. Hello, are you there?
Yes, hi, my name is Sharon.
Hi, Sharon. Thank you for calling in and joining.
Thank you. It sounds like you've turned adversity into inspiration, and that's extremely admirable. So, good for you.
I try my best.
I have a cat that I recently was diagnosed as blind, and hypothyroidism, and he's got just some high blood pressure issues. So I was wondering, you know, we're doing the best we can to manage his whatever's going on with him. But, you know, I was just wondering if he wants to communicate anything to me, because he's 13 years old, but he's still a little perky, and he's navigating around, and we've been giving him kidney food and, you know, giving him medicines and just trying to manage whatever we can do to make him as comfortable as possible. So I was just wondering, any thoughts on that?
Well, one thing is letting me do an energy healing session on him. I've had remarkable results with pets that are on the verge of dying, even.
Wow.
Not all made, but I've had some incredible, and the reviews are on my website, by the way, and they are from real people. So I really encourage you to get an energy session. It could turn things around 100 degrees. I know that he's not ready to go, okay? He's far from that, but he's always comfortable, we'll put it that way. Okay?
Right. Yeah. He's just, he's such a loving, wonderful animal, and he's not even an animal, he's human. So,
yes,
some people
are
more animals than animals.
That is very, very true.
Yeah, but he's just he's just loving. But okay, so, you know, as long as he's comfortable and he's happy, I mean, that's all I can for. And I'll definitely check.
Things that can help, and please check out my service. You'll find quite worth it. Anyway, I thank you so much, Sharon, for calling in tonight.
And thank you. Have a great evening. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Okay, well, that was an interesting call.
Yes, it was.
You know, I mean, this is quite the light worker subject, and I hope people are calling in on this, you know, if they're wondering about, you know, what they're going through, things like that. But there is another person, if they're still there. Let me see if I can get this person on. Hi there, this is Cherokee Billy. And
hi, Cherokee Billy.
Hello.
Hi. I looked at your website, and it's beautiful, and God grace to you for what you're doing, and I hope that you have a miracle yourself. Oh, my goodness. Well, thank you for being here for us. That was wonderful with the cat, and thank you for being a light worker. So I have a question. Where I'm at right now is my little space. The person next door to me, if you don't mind me asking, is the owner going to take some form of action towards the lady next door? Because I have a little office, but she did some bad things, and I was just wondering, she's two blocks, she's two places down. I don't think it's going to affect me because I'm not in it.
Well, she's definitely bringing a lot of problems onto herself. She is. So things will probably turn around quickly, okay? And I would recommend you check out my White Light Spiritual Protection on my website. Start doing that, and you'll see changes, okay?
Yes, Cherokee, you said that there's going to be action taken?
Yes, but I can't tell you what and in detail. Not here on the radio, okay?
I will check your website, and you get well, and anybody that's with Billy, please look her website. Anyway, thank you for taking my call.
Not a problem.
Thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay. Yeah. Anyway, sure wish somebody would call in about the light workers. Hey, don't any of you have any curiosity on that? Don't you wonder what might be going on for you? You know, I mean, because I feel there are more light workers than they know, and I'm here to try to help them to understand. You're one, even if you're not on some public platform or doing something like you, Ray. You know, you're working in a barn working with horses, but yet you are a light worker. You know, there's no question about it.
I could look at some of the horses.
Go ahead.
I could look at the horses and it's like we talk to each other, I'll look at them and say, hey, people think I'm crazy, but I go, hey, you know what? I can't do you today. I'll do you Wednesday or I'll do you next time I'm here. Or a horse is real hyper and everything else. And I'll just look at them and I'll just, in a calm voice, which is really what you should do, is say, hey, you know what? Calm down. Everything's okay. And they come right up to the gate and they look at me and I just, they just calm down. I can't explain it, but I talk to them. I look at them in the eye. They look at me in the eye. So evidently, I must be communicating somehow.
You are, and it's easy with animals. Humans are the problem. Animals never,
That's true.
and that's why, because animals, I don't care what animal it is, even down to a mouse, they know what you are saying. They understand you better than we understand them. And something I was thinking about, Ray, you and I have had our challenges on this road of life, but for many people, they don't quite understand it. But there's a wonderful poem by Robert Frost, The Road Less Taken, or The Road Less Traveled.
Yeah, I remember that.
One or the other. Oh, yeah. And that is a great poem to read, and I really recommend it because, for myself and for Ray, we have taken roads that we never thought we would. We've taken the road less traveled. And that's what's made our life different than many other people. They go the easiest way. They follow the crowd. They go in one direction. Well, that's not really the road less traveled, and that's where you want to go.
Just because the road's less traveled doesn't mean it's going to be easy, because 90% of the time it is not easy, because you're trying to learn. You're trying to do things differently. So, it's probably not going to be the easy or the easiest road that you've taken, but it's the most rewarding.
Absolutely. There's the point. It is the most rewarding. And, I want to thank you so much for being here with me, Ray. I really enjoy what you add to this, because you do have so much experience spiritually and materially and in so many ways. And I'm so grateful for your presence here. Means a lot.
I'm glad to be here.
Now, I see there's another caller here, so let's see what they've got to say. And area code 305. Hi there.
Hi, Billy. This is Beth.
Hey, Beth. I've known Beth for
how are you?
Several
for a
decades,
long time.
Yeah. Hi, Beth. I'm so glad you called in.
Yeah, this is a good show. I'm enjoying it. My girlfriend Judy is online listening to us, too.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you for sharing it with others.
Yes. I'm going through a lot, but I know I am a light worker.
Oh, yeah. Always. I've always known that.
Yeah. Question is, I have another light worker, friend of mine that's in the hospital. And you say we go through hard things.
Yes, we do.
Yep.
My life has been very difficult right now. So what is it that we can do to make us even more of a light worker?
Wow. Number
Does
one.
That make sense?
Number one, and I know you've heard me say it, and everyone else has, protect yourself spiritually. Because you're going to be under attack.
Right.
Because you are a light worker, you're going to be attacked far more than somebody who isn't doing a darn thing for the world. So number one, it's your spiritual protection, always. And I know you know about that. That's the number one thing you can do as a light worker. Because if you're doing that, not only are you protecting yourself, but the light from that protection is going out to others. So in a way, you're a blessing to them. like as you're walking down a street or in a mall or wherever you may be, you may be blessing people without you knowing it because of your light and the fact that you're beaming it because you have protected yourself. And like your friend in the hospital, if you go to see her or even remotely, send that same protection of God's white light and blue light to her and protect her in there. You know, hospitals are really filled with a lot of spirits because so many people die there. So you're dealing with a lot of spiritual issues.
And I'm aware of that.
Yeah, well, then now you know what to do for her.
Okay.
That will help her. It really will. And, you know, for yourself, I'm fully aware of everything you're going through. And all I can say is keep going forward. You're doing the best you can. It's going to change. I know it will.
I know. I feel it.
Yeah, and you're close to a verge. I know one of your concerns is about a job. And I know it's been difficult, but I feel, you know, right now it's summer and it's always difficult to get jobs. But, you know, come fall, then when things change, and they will. So kind of not be impatient. Know that everything you put forth now, be it applying or whatever, you're working towards what's going to come. So don't give up.
Right.
I defy everyone you possibly can. Yeah, you do.
Right.
You really do.
You're correct.
Because
thank you.
And again, I know you're a light worker. I know that. You know, it's always been there for you. But now it's a chance for you to expand it in new ways because you're going into a new phase of your life. And look at it as going to be better, a different phase than it has been before. If that makes any sense.
That's perfect.
You know, things are going to come around for you. Go ahead, Ray.
And the biggest thing is always move forward. I know about moving forward, you got one step forward, two steps back, and that doesn't get you any place but in trouble. Always got to move forward.
Yeah, even if it's by an inch, still creep along, you know, move forward. You know, the music that I have here is the introduction. The song is Break On Through to the Other Side. And that's what we all have to do is keep going forward, break on through to that other side. You know, we can't let us stay in the darkness, move forward into the light, back to the light worker. Light workers are in the light, even if they don't feel it. Even when you're down. You know, I mean, again, I often use Jesus because he's a great example of everything. You know, look at how, you know, he was hanging on a cross and asked God, why did you forsake me? And yet he knew him in a way we never will. And, you know, you can get down, but it doesn't mean you're out completely, and you're not.
Well, you know what I think is that I know I'm a light worker, and I can help everybody around me, but then when it comes to me, I kind of, like, shut down. So how can I bring that out to where you're helping yourself too?
Well, it's difficult. I think we all feel that way, what you're feeling.
Right.
You know? And like it's easier for me to do a reading or spiritual work for someone else than it is for me to do it on me.
Right.
Just it. Ray, you got any thoughts on this? I'd sure appreciate it.
Well, let me see here. I saw a show, or the name of the show is Angel. I'm not sure if it's a movie or TV show, what it is. But there's a thing, there's a comment in there, and it's all about the biblical days. One of the apostles went up to Jesus and says, you know, you heal everybody else. What about healing me? You know, why don't you heal me? And he said, what kind of message can you would do more by me not healing you? And he says, what do you mean? He says, could you picture you not being healed and still believing and praising and doing everything as you can? So, you know, and that's what it is.
Oh. That's interesting. Well, that's good. Thank you.
Yeah, it's a lot of, you know, thought. And I saw a movie, I don't know if I sent it to you, Beth, I may have, but I saw a movie on YouTube this week that really knocked me over. It's called The Perfect Stranger. I recommend people watching it. It is powerful, and it's about Jesus, but not in the way you would think. It's far removed. It's in our modern times, and I just thought it was a mind-blowing movie, so I hope you enjoy it.
What's the name of the movie again? I believe you sent it to me.
The Perfect Stranger.
Perfect Stranger. Okay.
I think I wrote, watch this movie, something like that.
Right.
So okay. Check your email, okay?
I think you did, and I was like, why is she sending me this?
There's a reason.
I wasn't sure if it was just like a it was just like a video, so I wasn't sure.
It's a movie.
I didn't watch it yet.
It's probably on Netflix and stuff, but I don't have a satellite or cable or anything, so the only way I watch movies is YouTube.
Okay.
I'm sure
I'll look at it.
Places. And I thank you for calling in, but we're down to just a couple of minutes, so we do have to move.
Okay, well, I'll say goodnight, and I'll keep listening, so keep up the good work, Billy. You're amazing, and if anybody's out there, you should get a reading with Billy, because Sue will help you.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Well, thank you very much.
Okay. Keep smiling.
Yeah, that was great. And by the way, my website is CherokeeBillySpiritualAdvisor.com. So you can go and check out my services, read from other people what they have thought. I have a blog. My new article is on the new moon that's coming up. I'm always writing, always working. Anyway, any thoughts here, Ray? Because we're coming up to about 2 minutes, 3 minutes here.
Okay. Well, I hope I helped that young lady at the last caller. I hope I helped her out some. And it's like you said, you know, you got to keep, because you start to go backwards, and I find myself doing that once in a while, going backwards. And I got to keep pushing forward along with everybody else to make things better. They may not be, even if they don't get better like tomorrow, eventually they will get better.
Yeah, exactly. Sooner or later, it will change. It's just waiting for the miracle to come and know that it is coming. I think that's the key, is knowing it's going to happen. Don't give up your hope, your faith. Faith is a hard thing and a hard concept for many people. But, you know, there's a verse in the Bible, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Faith is invisible.
Well, a lot of people want to walk by sight, strictly sight. It's the same old thing. If they can't see it, they don't believe it.
That is correct. And that is, you know, the people who are like the doubting Thomases, you know, you've got to believe, even when it's not in front of you. That is faith. And it's a difficult concept for many people, but faith is the thing that pulls us through to know that tomorrow will be different, that there is coming a change. And that's all I can say. But, you know, it's a good point. Faith is critical, is all I know. Now we're down to the last minute here. Is there anything final you want to say, Ray, as we come to the last few seconds?
I hope everybody keeps having faith in the light. You know, make sure everybody covers themselves with the white light and the blue light, and just hang in there, because things are going to get tough, and then they're going to get better.
Exactly. It goes in cycles, you know, and it won't last forever. Even though it may feel like it's forever, it isn't. I know. And I know Ray knows. We've been through some real hardships in our lives, and that's why we're here to kind of help you on this road of life with our little bit of knowledge. And I thank you so much, Ray, for joining me here. I really appreciate your taking the time out. It really was wonderful of you. And, you know, if people want to talk to Ray, you can contact me and I'll get him in touch with you. Anyway, God bless everybody and thank you. Good night.
Good night.